Jesus knows our think I'll stop this hand one first.
You use us, dear God, for your kingdom, Lord, as we just ask for all these mercies, dear Father, Lord, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. I just have one short announcement. The toilet facilities are located to the rear of the building. You can use the corner of our building, and there's a stairway you can get to the back. However, we just have a little situation with no water. You can use it still. That's okay. Right? So, hallelujah. Let's just sing the song, and I'll hand over to worship, or worship leader, Sister Tabitha. Hallelujah. much assistance are we? At this time, we will just have to have our scripture reading by none other than Sister Tabitha. Hallelujah.
Pleasant good morning again. Our scripture reading is taken from 1 Thessalonians chapter 13 to verses, chapter 4, from verse 13 to 18. And it says, brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be uninformed about those who sleep in death, so that you do not grieve like the rest of mankind who have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in him. According to the Lord's word, we tell you that we who are still alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangels, and with the trumpet call of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. After that, we who are still alive are left to be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. Thank you.
Thank you. I believe they would like to have a slideshow.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you very much for the assistance to the back. At this time, I would like to invite none other than her granddaughter, Abigail Pahau, to do the eulogy.
My beloved grandmother. For those of you who may not know me, my name is Abigail Bahal, the fullest grandchild. Born to Polly and Barstay Raghunathan, Rashid was born on December 3, 1952, being the second of 10 children from Bhuneshwar Charan. She completed her primary level education at the Monkey Town Primary School, then a secondary level at the St. Catherine's Girls College, and many years later, she further went on to do early childhood care education at the University of the Western Indies. After completing her secondary level education, Rajay started working at Kipalani's in San Fernando. After some time, she met my grandfather, Roel. They later got married on May 2nd, 1981, and after 2 years, the first bundle of joy was born, my father. Coincidentally, but rather funny, exactly 1 year, 1 month, and 1 day later, they had their daughter, my Aunt Diana. But that was a shocker. I mean, 1 year, 1 month, and 1 day apart.
Amen.
She had three wonderful grandchildren, Lexi, Liam, and myself. We all share some qualities of her. Liam shares so much, he shares birthday with her, imagine that. Lexi likes to sleep just like her, cover her whole body. And myself, I consider myself mentally strong, just like her. She always prayed for everyone. She would always pray with her family before they left the house for any big occasion. Example, like writing exams or going to an interview. She taught her kids about God and brought them up in the best way she could, given limited finances. She taught her kids to be resilient, respectful, kind, and committed. There are some things you should know. She loved to read, and she encouraged her kids and grandkids to do the same, where she would save articles for all of us to read, and she would think we would read it all. She loved to plant. She experienced much joy in planting vegetables in the backyard. She would get her kids involved by digging holes and dropping the seeds in. She could make a good pilori. She would fondly be remembered by her siblings for her pilori.
Yes.
She always liked to bake sponge cake, and I think my aunt followed in that same footsteps. She loved to watch Indian movies. They know long time families would sit down on a Sunday and watch an Indian movie on TV6. My grandmother would sit down there and not move from her chair until the movie done. And especially with her shower gun, she would sit down till the movie finished. She was fond of memories. Now, I don't want to call she a hoarder, but I would use the term collector. At any point in time when you enter our house, you can still find aunt items from my father's and aunt's childhood to present day. Although both kids, including myself, would throw things away, the things that we throw away would magically reappear into the house. My grandmother said to have an attitude of gratitude. She said this would make people feel appreciated. Now, a memory I can always remember was when my aunt and uncle just started dating. And they went out. I started to cry because I wanted to know why they won. My grandmother told me they wanted to loaf. So I tell her, I was like, okay, I want a small loaf. Them can have the big loaf. She made it her business and called them, and they ended up coming back for me. And she always made me feel appreciated. And she did have a range of job experience. Besides working at Kipalani's and selling papers, she taught Sunday school, She was a teacher, stranger, ECCE center, and also a typewriting teacher for White Up at Barbara West Secondary School. As I end here, there's one thing everyone, especially our family, should know. There was a time when she recognized she started losing her memory. From that day, she would write important notes on papers. Although she may not remember where her papers were, there was one note that was important, and in this note she wrote, "I know that I am forgetting a lot, but she wanted her family to know that she loved them very dearly." Thank you.
Thank you very much, Abigail. Such wonderful and fun memories we have to hold on. Saraji was indeed a wonderful person. I'll never forget how she used to come to church here. I tell you, our church wasn't like how it used to look now, but you know, she always held her Bible and she came to church. She and Sister Rina. And you know, these elders have set the stage for our young people to follow. And we thank God for the lives that they lived and they showed us the way and all the good things in life. Hallelujah. At this time, I would like to invite our pastor as he comes to deliver the word this morning for us. Let's welcome him as he comes. Hallelujah.
Good morning to everyone. Speaking about Sister Raj Day, love Indian movies. I grew up in those days too. It was this Sunday morning that we came to church and left our two children home with their auntie, who was just a few years, probably 2 or 3 years older than them. So when we returned home from service, they all ran out, all three of them ran out of the house and grabbed us, and they started to say, "Moti Moti Hama Hama Head." We don't know what was happening, you know. Then we, "What is all this about?" He said they were watching an Indian movie Sunday morning. And what's the name of the movie? "Moti Moti Hama Hama Head." We kind of figured it out. It was "Moti Namahe." "Moti is my name." That's the English, I think, for that. "Moti is my name. Moti Namahe. Moti Moti Namahe." Well, this morning, we are pressed for time. We only have 10 minutes again to leave this place. But I just want to leave a little thought with you. We have had so much speaking at the wake, those who have been at the wake. We had people from Freeport in the service, you know, and other people from all over the country. And I want to just remind us this morning, if I may, Jesus was heading to Calvary. To him, Calvary, and to the people and his disciples, it was not a pleasant place to be heading. Because at Calvary, the place called Golgotha, he would be crucified. Before he would have been crucified, he was tied to what was called a whipping post. And there he took 39 stripes, which was the allotted amount for people whom the Roman government and the Jewish Sanhedrin Council and the scribes and Pharisees recommended. For people who they thought violated their laws, the Romans were very adamant concerning Jesus because he declared himself to be king. And the Jewish or religious society thought that when Jesus said he is the Son of God, they thought that was violation to their monotheistic theology, and that simply means that there is one, only one true God. And when he said he was a Son of God, he places himself on the same level with God, the creator of the heavens and the earth. And as we were saying last night, this world was created by Christ Jesus. In the book of John, if you would want to remember, John chapter 1, the first few verses, the Gospel according to John, it said that without him, Jesus, was nothing made that was made.
Amen.
And that's important, because every one of us here in this place was created before eternity. You and I were created. You and I came into this world all because of his power, his authority, and his love. So I want to remind us this morning that Jesus loves you. And he went to that place called Golgotha, crucified at the place called Calvary for you and I. Because you and I, as I said before, deserve to die because of our sins and our sinful ways. And there is no amount of good that you can do that could erase the evil, the wrong, the sins that we would have committed. And therefore, God had to do something for us, and that is taking your sins and my sins, which we could not have had removed, and place it on his Son. And that's why Jesus died at Calvary. He died in your place. Amen. What a Savior. What a Lord. What a Creator who loves us, who cares about us, and cares about your eternity. Because if there is one thing that will prevent you and I from entering into eternity, having eternal life, it's our sins. And God has given us a privilege, an opportunity, for as many as believe him, or in Christ Jesus, for as many of us who believe that he is Lord, that he is the Savior of all mankind, that he is the answer to all our questions concerning life and eternity, you shall have eternal life. I want to ask you this morning, in a very concise way, to think what I've just said. Get yourself a Bible and read it for yourself. That Jesus is the way to God. No other way but Jesus. He is the truth that you want to know about, and that you have been searching for all these years. And he is the life that you want to have. If you have Jesus, you will know the way. If you have Jesus, you know the truth. You would have come into an experience of the truth. If you have Jesus, you have eternal life. God bless you so much. We want to have a viewing of the body for some of you who cannot go with us to the creek. So, we would probably want to, those that are in charge, just shift the coffin a little bit to my right, just a little bit this way, so that we could come and go out. Okay? Just a little bit. So we'll start from this side, the viewing. We will leave the family for last, all the families, siblings. You will remain for last so that you will have your time. But just go this way a little bit. And yeah, just about 2 feet or so. So we can have the entrance here. Okay, great. Good. And you can bring it back this way as well. Good. So we will start from this side. Remember all the children, grandchildren, sisters, and all the others that are directly connected with Sister Rajdi. You hold back a little bit. And the rest of us, you begin to come and view the body, and you could go this way. All right? So Sister Kamara will play. Have some music for us. Yeah. She will sing. All right, okay, she will sing.
Okay, let's begin. We have limited time. But you want to say you want to start over the service? It was so good. Okay, so those friends and relatives, you can begin to come. Remember all the children, all the grandchildren, remain for last, all right?
Thank you.
So let's head down to the mosquito green. Have a table person here from the funeral home.
Yeah.
That
Thank you.
But before we commit the body, we just want to sing a verse or two of a chorus, okay? When on your program, if you have a program, when the rule is called up, you're done.
The Lord shall sound and the land shall leap, and the morning brings eternal bright and fair. When the same earth shall gather under on the other side, and the roll is drawn up yonder of the day. And the glory of his resurrection share. When his chosen one shall gather to the home beyond the sea, and the roll is full of yonder, I'll be there.
For those who were not at the church or you still want to have your last view, we will do that now as we get ready to commit the body. Okay, so you can go ahead while we make preparations.
Often forfeit, oh,
Which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. Why we look at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. For as much as it pleased Almighty God to of his mercy to take back unto himself the soul of our beloved Sister Rajdev, we therefore commit her body, ashes to ashes and dust to dust, in the sure and certain hope that the spirit which has returned unto God who gave it will be reunited with a resurrected body at the second coming of Christ, when the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and with the trump of God. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall raise incorruptible. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. Then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us all, both now and forevermore. Amen.
Get me going. Do you want to come with the
sheet?
Right?